I am proud to stand among the dull-witted of Broadway. I mean, just to look at your needy, desperate faces makes me want to spread my largesse. Oh, I say, what do you think you're doing? Yes, well, I'm here to introduce a number from this smart and hilarious new musical about a charming chap who's killing all his relatives so that he can inherit a magnificent fortune. Oh, I say there. In this scene, Monty Navarro's enjoying a tryst with his very married mistress, Sibella, when the virtuous Phoebe arrives quite unexpectedly with the answer to a question Monty has yet to pose. I give you best musical nominee, A Gentleman's Guide to Love and Murder.
Who could that be?
I haven't the foggiest. Quick, go into the bedroom. No. Shut the door.
Yes.
Be very still.
I decided to marry you. I decided though Henry's gone that life goes on for me. I have thoroughly thought it through, and the man that I want is you. Though it's true there are quite a few who strongly disagree, nonetheless I will marry you. I confess that I'm frightened too, but unless I am wrong you long for love as much as I. This is quite a conventional, I admit, but why should that matter a whit? And if you do not say yes at once, I think I'll die.
Miss Dicewith, you've rendered me speechless. May I call you Phoebe?
What am I doing here? This could be dangerous if I'm discovered. Imagine the scandal, and I couldn't handle a scandal so risible. I'll stay invisible, still as can be. But what's going on in there? I can hear voices. I recognize Monty, but is that a woman? And if that's a woman, then what is she doing here? Is it the cousin I wish I could see? If it's that cousin, it might just be business. It's family business, and none of my business. But why is she here in the home of a bachelor? Of course, one could point out that I'm here as well, but does she not realize this situation puts her reputation severely in question? The mere suggestion could cause a sensation, and I cannot hear, which is hell.
I
could go home.
I'll be scorned if I marry
you. I should go. Still, I decided to lay my life and be a wife again. Who will leave on my life as
I should be off.
After grieving, I quickly
he makes me laugh.
There is nothing
can bend the will like half a steel man.
And there's goodness to spare in you.
Isn't this fun?
And the gentleness there in you.
Isn't she done?
You have taken a wounded bird and taught her how to fly.
This is my
life. This is quite unconventional. Is it not? Rather a turn in the plot. And so will I be your fiancé.
Why don't you send the cow away?
Baby, darling,
when I call this day, I think I'll cry.
Go!
What was that?
What was what?
That sound. Is there someone here?
Oh, pay no attention. That's my new manservant. He's just finding his way around. I'll be with you in a moment! Wadsworth! Isn't this madness? Who could foresee how one trick of timing could ruin it all? One in the parlor, one in the bedroom, nothing between them but me and a wall. Look at Phoebe, noble and pious, my esteem for only grows. But when I am with Phoebe, I am on fire, thinking of Sibella, full of desire, passion, and dare I say it, love. But when I'm with Sibella, whom do I admire? None but Phoebe, perfect and lovely, who couldn't love her, heaven knows. Round and round and round it goes. How happy I'd be to be at your disposal. My darling, of course I accept your proposal.
Now we shall kiss.
That would be bliss.
Darling, but first I'll say this. I've decided to marry you.
Phoebe,
I decided to marry you. What have you to do? I've been
forward
for and set me free.
And there's a bell.
Oh,
yes, I'm honored to marry you.
Monty,
marry you,
Monty.
Phoebe,
look what you've done to me.
Bestowment. Yes, Wadsworth, I told you! Be just a moment!
Now, Monty, dear, I think I now should go.
Oh, oh.
But I still want to marry you.
Even so.
I decided to marry you.
Just go.
How I'm longing to marry you.
Hello.
Yes, I'm delighted to marry you. Marry you, marry you. She must go.
Go.